to on our channel, that is Achieve IAS. So friends, let me tell you that as we told you that we will be starting a series that will be called by name Data Analysis Substantiating Opinions. So in pursuance of that announcement, we have come up with this innovative series in which we will be discussing data from your we can say objective perspective, so that you people can get an idea about any situation by seeing its data. So this video and the purpose of this series is not just to target your exams, or some students may say okay, this is for substantiating our opinions, but this is in general, this series will also help you in kind of getting a comprehensive idea of about anything, about gravity of a problem, about the seriousness of an issue. So it is not just limited to students. All people who are concerned with a particular issue, those can utilize this data, because this is not our data. We clearly say that this is not our data. We will be presenting this data to you at single point. So if we are analyzing today we will be discussing the impact of human activity on global ecology and biodiversity. So in this case, we will be incorporating different reports that are there in public domain, that might be of government, that might be of leading international institutions of the world, or that might be of independent non-governmental organizations. So before starting, let me tell you friends that this the purpose of this video is not to carry out any malicious propaganda. So this is just an objective observation, and the purpose of this is to make you aware about different things. So you may or may not accept this data. We are not saying that please accept and take it as valid, but certainly for the purpose of authentication and for the purpose of genuineness, we are taking the data only from genuine reports that are objective and that have not been released with the intention of any malicious propaganda. So let's start our discussion, friends. So living planet, now we will be first discussing living planet report 2018. So why we will be discussing? Because the topic is impact of human activity on this global ecosystem and biodiversity. So that can't be discussed if we don't look at Living Planet report that is released by Worldwide Fund for Nature. So let's see what are the observations of it. So first observation is that global wildlife population has declined by 60% between 1997 and 2014. So as per this report, the wildlife population has seen such a large decline of 60%. And apart from it, it also observed that only 25% of the global land is that which is untouched by human activity. That is, the human activity is increasing, and it is increasing, and human activity is increasingly encroaching upon hitherto unused areas. So this is leading to land use change and other ecological consequences, and also as is observed by this report. So the wildlife population has declined by 60%, but the highest decline has been seen in freshwater species, which have seen a decline of 83%. So also it observes that 87% of the wetlands that were there since 1970s, they have been kind of, we can say, vanished. Why they are vanished? Because they have been subjected to alternate land use. So human activity, suppose for example expanding agriculture or making a kind of building structures over these wetlands. So certainly this affects our ecosystem, our ecology, and the delicate balance that the nature has kept with the different, we can say, aspects of the nature or environment. So then global ecological footprint also observed by this report that this global ecological footprint of human beings has seen a jump to the tune of 190% since 1960. So since 1960, our global ecological footprint has seen a 190% rise. So this is quite significant, and you may know that what will be the consequences of it. So here we are not analyzing the consequences, because our video is solely focused upon data. You may use it in any way you want to. So here we will be not suggesting you any way forward or any other thing. So we are just highlighting the report and what this could mean. So what could this could mean, you have to infer it on your own. So also then it highlighted that the chief factors that were that are responsible for this are the agriculture and the over exploitation of natural resources. So agriculture is making a significant effect on your entire ecosystem, as well as over exploitation of natural resources. So you might say that okay, we have to do agriculture, ultimately we have to survive. But the thing is that why agriculture is affecting, because population is increasing, and when population is increasing, certainly burden on the natural resources that may be biotic or abiotic is increasing, as well as the food demand is increasing. So increasingly the land having different purpose at that land has been changed, and that has land has been used subjected to different land use. So increasingly agriculture is expanding. So these are the chief factors which are according to the report are the important determinants of determinants of everything that is happening on planet relating to ecology and the biodiversity and entire ecosystem. So this is basically Living Planet Report 2018, and we will also be looking at one more report, because as I have told you that here we will be giving you data at a single point. So we will be analyzing one more report. So this report is basically named as Global Assessment Report on Biodiversity and Ecosystem Services. So this report was prepared by Intergovernmental Science Policy Platform on Biodiversity and Ecosystem Services. So what was the observation of this report? So first observation that this comprehensive report released by as I have told you, this organization, it observed that nature is depleting at an unprecedented rate in human history. So please note the word unprecedented. So never has the nature depleted to such an extent in the human history at which it is depleting now. So other thing is that report observes that nearly 1 million species, that is 10 lakh species, are on the verge of extinction. So this could what this could mean, you can gauge by the interdependence of the different life forms on the earth. So there are food chains, food webs, and then there are other forms of dependence on the nature, for example for medicine, for other ecological services, for other needs, for energy, for food, and then for your recreational services, and also employment services that are provided by the nature. So 1 million species are on the verge of extinction. If the report says that the current relationship that the human beings have with nature is not revamped, because currently the relationship is of over exploitation. So then there is other thing that is observed by this global report, that there are nearly 680 vertebrate species that have gone extinct since 16th century. So why this 16th century has been used as a benchmark by the report? Because 16th century was the century from which the human beings so basic thing is that that human beings have always interacted with nature, but from this period this interaction has gone a significant transformation, and this significant transformation has resulted in negative effects on nature. So you can observe that 680 vertebrate species have gone extinct. How this could play out on the larger picture, so you can obviously judge by if you have any a little bit about idea about the complex nature and complex relationship between the different biotic and abiotic components of the nature. So then there is also one more observation by this report that since 16th century 9% of the domesticated mammals, so earlier that domesticated for food and agriculture, they have gone extinct, and currently those which are domesticated, they are also facing a threat of extinction. So other thing is that that is observed by the report is that 23% of the global land has experienced reduced productivity. So you can see that obviously the pressure on the land is increasing, pressure on the food demand is increasing, so human beings are increasingly using natural resources as well as chemical fertilizers. So all these things that are reinforcing each other, they are cumulatively impacting your entire nature. So 23% decline in global land productivity. So that is a kind of thing of concern, because obviously our population is increasing, but our land's productive capability is decreasing. So then other thing is that 100 to 300 people are at risk of floods and hurricanes due to loss of coastal habitats and protection. So coastal habitats and protection is basically affected, because 100 to 300 million people are at the risk because there is a change in land use at the coastal zones as well. So then other thing is that 33% of the coral forming reefs are threatened. So if coral forming reefs are there, an important base in your entire food chain and food web process of the marine life. And then other thing is that there is also loss of pollinator species. So what are these pollinator species? They are basically animal or other species which are responsible for pollination of plant species. So due to which this important flowering of the plant flowers takes place, fruits takes place, and then important production of the global crops takes place. But due to loss of these pollinator species, the pollination is not happening, and this the report has observed that is causing a loss of worth of $577 billion to your entire global food crop production. And as 75% of the global crops are dependent on these species, and in one way or the other. So these are the broad observations of this report. So now as I've told you, 100 to 300 million people are at the risk of floods and hurricanes due to loss of coastal habitats and protection. So so what next? So what should we do? So as I've told you, friends, we can't suggest you way forward. We can suggest you, but we don't want to suggest here, because the purpose of this video is just to analyze the data. So what next? Simple thing which we want to say is that please save nature and please save planet. And how can you do so? So simple thing is, Mahatma Gandhi said, the great leader of the father of the nation, he once said that be the change you want to see in others. So don't look upon the world that what it is doing. Focus on yourself, then see what you can do, figure out what contribution you can make. So we have given you the video so to highlight the gravity of the problem, so you can bring change in yourself. You can also one more thing you can do for our benefit as well as for the nature's benefit as well, you can share this video so that others can see. And see, as you might say that okay, so you are doing it for self-interest. So if we even accept that we are doing it in self-interest, but ultimately that is helping in highlighting the situation, the gravity of the situation. So please do ensure that you share this video, and if you like this video, do ensure that you like it. So if you have any feedback to give, if you have any we can say any moral suggestion that you have to give, then you can do so in the comment box as well. So this is all about, friends, today's video. And lastly, you can visit our website, that is www.achieveias.co.in, for more such information. So this is all about today's video. Thank you, have a very nice day ahead. Do ensure that you subscribe to our channel. So thank you.